Hi everyone. Okay, I got tagged by Whitetail Bushcraft. Good channel, by the way, if anyone isn't such, go check him out. Good people. And it was about what in a survivor situation, what would you take? And I suppose everything's so unspecific. For me down here, well, first of all, it's quite a hard question, really. And I know everyone's leaning to fire, and I absolutely agree. But mine's slightly different here. I'm pretty good with fire. I can get fire going pretty easy. Food would be the biggest issue here, because it's nearly all farmland. So what we've got a lot of is streams and rivers. So for me to be able to feed my family, or just myself, I could feed as many people that, well, you know, within reason. But the water's the key for me. So this is the one item I would have. There's not much else I couldn't make out of nature. And around here, there's wild herbs and stuff, but, you know, you're not really going to get a fill. So this is what I would go for. And it's a small travel fishing kit. Tiny reel. You can see it compared to my hand. I mean, a little tiny one. It's a 5-piece rod. And a little basic kit. So, just a few little very light things, because it's so much easier to catch a lot of small fish than it is to catch one big one. Everyone goes for the big one, but while they're still fishing, I'm filling my face with you know, 20, 30, 40 small fish. And I'm stuffed, you know? So, you know, that's the way I'd look at it. But with this compact fishing rod, it's a travel kit, I'm alright. And I don't mind sushi either. Shelter's easy. Get your greens from the hedgerow. You know, just bow drill a fire, no big deal here. Knife's easy. Just split a rock and a razor. Get a lot of slate in Wales. But no, the big one, the killer around here, it's not going to be water. It's got lots of it. Is food. And so the easiest and, you know, highest value protein is fish. There's plenty of rabbits, so you could easily get some fence wire or something like that. And you know, make snares, and, you know, easily get something to you know, snare up a couple of fields. Navigation's no big deal, as long as you know how to read the sun. So yeah, it comes down to food for me. Well, if I have this, I can feed everyone, and the rest is a non-issue. One thing's a bit of a pain, we don't have that much birch around here. So, you know, making containers and using the bark isn't always readily available. But I think this is about a 4-pound line on here. It's a double strength line. It's quite a long rod when you put it together. But that would do it. That would do it for me. Because everything else would be in hand, you know? Even if I've got the kids and the missus with me. I can't see there being, you know, it's not going to be the Hilton, is it? But so, knife would be a luxury item. Of course, the first thing I thought about was, what would I take if I had to go wild, what one item? Of course, the first thing I thought of was my local bushcraft shop, my favourite bushcraft shop. Imagine taking that with you. That'd be nice, wouldn't it? But there we go. That's what I would take. And I, you know, I've read reports and, you know, testimonies of people that have been, you know, they've gone to sea and they've had a problem and they've ended up being stranded. And when they've just been catching fish from their survival kit, and obviously fresh water is an issue for them, isn't it? And what they used to save is like the liver and the eye sockets were a favourite, eyeballs, sorry, were a favourite for them, of the fish, because they had the most liquid in them, and they saved them till last. Or if they were, you know, feeling a bit cheeky, they'd have them first, but that was always the best bit after, you know, weeks and weeks just floating around the med or something, you know? It's a handy thing, a fish. And of course your leftovers, you know, fins and stuff, you know, you can make lures. And but for my geographical area, you know, give or take 200-300 miles and around, you know, in a circle, but yeah, that would be the one. Memory card 4. You gotta love it. So there we are. That's what I'd say. That's for me in my area. That'd see me through. Definitely. Now I gotta tag someone. I'm not gonna tag three. I'm just gonna tag one person because I'm curious what he'd actually say. Probably already knows who it is. Pete up in Alaska. He's got a great channel, by the way. If anyone hasn't subbed to him, I'll leave the link at the bottom. Check him out. He's a good lad. He knows a bit about everything. He's right in the mix, and he's a tidy lad as well. So I'll leave a link in there. So Pete, you're stuck with it now. What item would you take? And don't take him more. They fall to pieces. Oh, I was just a lucky and it was mine. Anyway, I'll leave it there. So, guys.